Hi, this is Pradeep Kumar Reddy. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Dagger in an Android app. Let's start with introduction to Dagger. Dagger is a fully static compile time dependency injection framework for Java, Kotlin, and Android. Then the question arises, what is dependency injection? Dependency injection is a programming technique that makes a class independent of its dependencies. What does this mean? Dependency injection, the basic idea of dependency injection is we should not create instances of any of the classes in our application by ourselves. Instead, it should be delegated to dependency injection frameworks. As the control of creating dependencies is moved out of the class itself, dependency injection is also called as inversion of control principle, IOC. Then there are two types of dependency injections. One is reflection based solutions that connect dependencies at runtime. The other one is static solutions that generate the code to connect dependencies at compile time. Dagger comes under the second category. And in the first category, the example is Juice. Juice is reflection based solution. Apart from Dagger, there are many other dependency injection frameworks available. I have listed few of them here. Those are Butterknife, RoboJuice, Coin, Codin, and Hilt. By using dependency injection by implementing dependency injection in our app, these are the advantages that we are going to get: reusability of the code, ease of refactoring the code, and ease of testing. Now let's look at some Dagger terminology. The first one is application graph or dependency graph. So it is the representation of all the classes in an application and their associated dependencies makes up the application graph. Let me show you an example to understand this. So this is how a dependency graph or application graph will look like. Here you can see four activities: registration activity, login activity, main activity, and settings activity. So these activities are in turn dependent on the view models, their respective view models. And those view models are dependent on some other classes like user manager and user data repository. So this is how a dependency graph or application graph will look like. Now I think the definition makes sense. Representation of all the classes in an application and their associated dependencies makes up the application graph. Then scopes. Decides whether to reuse a dependency or create a new instance. See, when we are creating the instances of classes ourselves, we have control, so we can decide which class has to be a singleton or which class should not be a singleton. But when Dagger is creating the dependencies, we need to tell Dagger the same thing, and the way to tell is using scopes. Then components. Component is to create a graph of dependencies. We can think of a component will keep track of all the classes and their associated dependencies. We can think of subcomponents as a subgraph of classes in an application. So subcomponent will be derived from the other parent component, and it is used for creating specific flows in an app. Then modules, another way of adding types or classes to dependency graph when constructor injection does not work. Basically, modules are used to tell Dagger how to create instances of Android framework classes, like how to create instances of shared preferences and things like that. Now that we have looked at the Dagger terminology, most of this annotations, Dagger annotations, will be self-explanatory. The first one is @inject. @inject is used to tell Dagger how to create instances of classes. Cutting it can be used in two places. One is we can use it for a constructor. In front of the constructor we can use attinger, and the other place is for fields of a class we can use attinger. The first one, if we use attinger before a constructor, it is called constructor injection. If we use attinger for a field, that is called field injection. So attinger used to tell Dagger how to create instances of that class. Then the second one is at component. This is used to create a Dagger component. And then at singleton and at scope, these are scope annotations. The difference between at singleton and at scope is at singleton is predefined, whereas we use at scope to create a custom scope. When at singleton is already used for one component, the same annotation cannot be used for another component. In that case, we create a custom scope using at scope and use that. Then at module, it is used to create a Dagger module. And the at provides and at binds are the annotations which are used inside a Dagger module. These are used to tell Dagger how to create instances of classes that are mentioned inside a module. And then at subcomponent is used to create a subcomponent. And for every class in the application graph, Dagger generates a factory type class that it uses internally to get instances of that type. This is the dependency graph of the application that we are going to work on to implement Dagger. Like I said earlier, this application has four activities which are dependent on their respective view models, and the view models are in turn dependent on other classes. Now we are going to refactor the code in this application to implement Dagger. After refactoring the code to implement Dagger, the application graph will look like this. So in this application graph, you can see there are three subcomponents that are derived from one parent component. How did we come up with this subcomponents, and how did we create this hierarchy of subcomponents and parent component? The reason is simple. Keep all the objects that should be available for entire duration of the app in the app component. And keep all the objects that are tied to the activity lifecycle in a subcomponent. Like for example, we want the registration component and the associated objects of registration component to be destroyed when the registration activity finishes. So for that, we created a subcomponent called registration component, and we'll tie that component to the registration activity so that whenever the activity finishes, this registration component will get destroyed. Similarly, we created the other two components, user component and login component. That's how we should come up with the hierarchy of subcomponents and parent component. Then you can see the white dot on context and user manager. What does that indicate? Only one instance of context and user manager are created in the app component, and Dagger provides the same instance everywhere dependency injection is requested in other classes. Similarly, here registration view model is a singleton. The same instance of registration view model is shared by all the classes that are using this component. Whereas enter details view model is not a singleton in this component. Similarly, in user component, user data repository is a singleton that is represented by this yellow dot. Whereas the other two view models are not singletons. User data repository is a singleton which is shared by all the classes that are using this component. that was the explanation of this graph. Now we are going to, by referring this graph, we are going to refactor the code in this application to implement Dagger. Let's start defining the registration component in the code. In the registration component, there are two classes, registration view model and enter details view model. To tell Dagger how to create instances of these classes, we need to add at inject annotation to those constructors. Let's start with that. At inject space constructor. Import this. So in Kotlin primary constructor, we don't have to use the constructor keyword, but when we use any annotations, it is mandatory to use the constructor keyword. Here we are using the annotation, so I am adding the constructor keyword. And similarly, we'll do that for enter details view model at inject constructor. When we add at inject constructor in front of a constructor, at inject annotation in front of a constructor, this is called as constructor injection. Okay, then next thing is we'll define the registration subcomponent. The subcomponent is an interface, so we'll select the interface registration subcomponent. And to this, I'll add the annotation subcomponent. Inside this, we'll create a factory for creating the instances of this component. Interface factory fun. Create registration subcomponent. The annotation for this is subcomponent dot factory. So here the create method name is our choice. We can give the name any name we want, but it's by convention we give the name as create. Dagger doesn't care about the method names. It only cares about the parameters that we pass to the method names and also the return types of the method names. Here, what Dagger looks for is the return type, registration subcomponent. Then, the next thing is tell Dagger all the classes that are going to use this component. How do we know that? From the graph, we can see that there are three classes that are using registration component. Those are terms and conditions fragment, registration activity, and enter details fragment. So now go back to the code. Here we'll add those three classes. Fun, inject, registration activity. Fun inject terms and conditions fragment. Fun inject enter details fragment. As I said, even inject name is not mandatory. Method names are our choice. What Dagger case about is the parameters that we pass to the method names and the return types of the methods. Here I am using inject is by convention. So now we defined the subcomponent. One thing that is left out in registration component is we need to tell that Dagger that registration view model is a singleton. To do that, we need to create a scope annotation and use that annotation for both registration component and registration view model.
Let's define the scope annotation. I'm going to name this annotation, scope annotation, as activity scope, as this view model is scope is limited to the life cycle of the activity. I'm going to name it as activity scope. It's an annotation class, and annotations we need to use here is scope, and then must be documented. Use this annotation if you want this to be documented. Then at retention value equal to annotation retention dot runtime. So now we have defined the activity scope. This we are going to use it for our subcomponent here at activity scope, and the same thing we are going to give it to use it for registration view model activity scope. By doing this, what we are telling Dagger is registration view model is a singleton in registration subcomponent. Now we are done with the code changes for registration subcomponent. Similar to how we defined registration component, now we will define the user component. The first step is add the @inject annotation to the these classes that are present in the user component: settings view model, main view model, and user data repository. Let's start with that. @inject constructor. Then we'll add the same thing to main view model. @inject constructor. Then the same thing to user data repository. @inject constructor. Then the next step is to define the user component, subcomponent. As I told, the subcomponent is an interface. User component. The annotation for this is subcomponent. Inside that, we will create a factory to create instances of this component. Interface factory. Inside that we'll create a method create which returns user subcomponent. And the annotation for this is subcomponent dot factory. Then tell Dagger classes that are going to use this component. From the graph, we can see that main activity and settings activity are using the user component. Let's add these two activities in the user component interface. Fun inject main activity. Inject settings activity. So with this, user subcomponent is defined. Then one thing that is left out is we need to tell which classes in the subcomponent are singletons. For that, we need to define a annotation scope annotation. Let's define the. So for that, I'm not going to reuse the activity scope, because so here this subcomponent is being used by multiple activities, so I'm not using the activity scope. Here I'll call as not user scope. I'll copy paste the existing thing because it's going to be the same except the name. I'll rename this class name logged user scope, and I'll use this annotation for user subcomponent. And the same thing I'll give it for user data repository, because the user data repository is the class we want to make a singleton in user subcomponent. So with this our user subcomponent is defined. Now let's define the last subcomponent in this graph, which is login component. First step is we'll add the @inject annotation. Then we'll define the login subcomponent. Then we'll list out all the classes that are going to use this login subcomponent. It's only one class, which is the login activity. That's all. We're done with the login subcomponent. We are done with defining all the three subcomponents. Now let's define the parent component. It is called as app component. App component provides four objects. One is context, then user manager, registration component factory, and login component factory. As usual, we will start with @inject annotation. Then we'll define the app component. The annotation here we should use is component. Earlier for subcomponents we were using @subcomponent. Here we should use @component. Then @component.factory interface factory fun create @binds instance context returns app component. As we have seen in the graph, app component provides the instance of context. For that we are passing context to this create method. Use this annotation @bind instance when we need to get instances of classes that are not part of our application graph. Context is not part of our application, it is from the framework class. So to provide those instances we should use @binds instance. So we have provided the factory method to create instances of app component. Then let's add the other classes of the app component. Fun, registration component. It should return registration subcomponent dot factory. Fun, login subcomponent. This should return the login subcomponent dot factory. Then fun user manager. This should return the user manager. As I already told you, the method names registration component, login subcomponent, and user manager, these are our choice. Dagger doesn't care about the method names, it only cares about the return types of the methods and the arguments that we pass to the method name. Still, there are two changes that we need to do in app component. One is we need to make the user manager as a singleton,
The other thing is we need to define this storage module. Here storage is an interface. For interfaces we need to tell Dagger that which implementation of the interface has to be provided when dependency injection is requested. The way to tell is by defining Dagger modules. So let's do those changes. First, let's make user manager as a singleton. For that, we are adding the @singleton annotation. You might get doubt that why we did not use the @singleton annotation for the subcomponents. It is because once it is used in the parent component, it cannot be reused in the subcomponents. The siblings subcomponents can share the same annotation, but parent component and the subcomponent cannot share the same annotation. That's the reason why we have created separate custom scope annotations. The annotation that we need to use to create a Dagger module is @module. Inside this, we'll create a function provide storage. Again, the method name is our choice. It should return in the interface type the storage. Which implementation of the interface is provided inside the as parameters to the function name. Shared preferences storage. Shared preferences storage is a class that implements that storage interface. Let's go to that class and add @inject. @inject constructor. Now come back to the storage module. So here for this method we need to give the annotation @binds. As @binds can be used only for abstract methods, make this method as abstract. And make also the class as abstract, because abstract methods can be there only in abstract classes. So now we have defined a Dagger module. What this means is, whenever dependency injection is requested on this storage type interface, provide the implementation of storage, shared preference storage. One last thing we need to do to complete building this dependency graph is we need to link up all these three subcomponents to the app component and also the storage module, this Dagger module, to the app component. To link this subcomponents to the app component, what we will do is we'll create a module and add all the subcomponents to that module, and that module we'll use in app component. Let's define a Dagger module for all our subcomponents. @module. Inside this module, we'll specify all our subcomponents. Subcomponents is equal to is an array. We have subcomponents like registration subcomponent, then login subcomponent, then user subcomponent. Now we'll add Dagger modules to the app component. So here we'll say modules is an array. We'll specify the modules here. App subcomponents, and the other module is storage module. With this, building our dependency graph is complete. Now we will request Dagger to provide the dependencies for all our fragments and activity classes using this dependency graph. But to start using this dependency graph, we need to create instances of app component and all the other subcomponents. Let's start creating that. We will create the app component instance in the application class, because we want all the objects that are part of app component to be available for entire duration of the application. So here val app component by lazy dagger app component dot factory dot create. application, we are passing the application context. So here we are doing the lazy initialization. Here lazy is a function which takes a lambda. So this will be, this variable will be initialized the first time when it is accessed. And here the Dagger app component is generated by Dagger. If we go to the implementation, app component is what we defined. Using this, Dagger has generated this code, and using that we are creating the instance of app component. Then the next step is, one by one we'll go to all the activity and fragment classes, and then we'll remove the manual dependencies that we are already using, and then we will request Dagger to provide those dependencies for us. Let's start with the registration activity. Registration activity is using the registration subcomponent. So we want Dagger to provide the registration view model. So we'll remove this manual dependency, and for this we'll add the annotation at inject. So if we use at inject for a field, this is called field injection. Earlier we were adding at inject for a constructor, that is constructor injection. This is field injection. Let's add one more variable, let init var registration component, registration subcomponent. This will be used in the fragments. Now we'll request Dagger to provide the dependencies in this class. Registration subcomponent equal to application as my application dot app component dot registration component dot create. Then registration subcomponent dot inject of this. So this is how we request the Dagger to provide the dependencies from the registration component to this class. It is generally best practice to request Dagger to provide dependencies to write these statements before the super.onCreate in onCreate method. We will repeat the same steps for fragments inside the registration activity. Here we want Dagger to provide these dependencies. So we'll say at inject and at inject cannot be used for private variables, so I'll remove this private keyword, private modifier. Then we'll remove the manual dependencies. Then in a fragment, the best practice to request for dependencies is in onAttach method. We'll override the onAttach method. After the super.onAttach, we'll request for the Dagger to provide the dependencies in this class. So require activity as registration activity dot registration subcomponent dot inject of this. And then we'll go to the other fragment. Here also the same thing, we'll repeat that step, remove the private, as inject cannot be used for private variables, and then remove the manual dependency. Override the onAttach method and request for the dependencies. Require activity as registration activity dot registration subcomponent dot inject of this. As I said, in a fragment the best place to request for, or it is a best practice to request for dependency Dagger dependencies in onAttach method after super.onAttach. Whereas in activity, the best practice is to request it before the super.onCreate in onCreate method. Similarly, you can request Dagger to provide dependencies in other activity classes. Let's move on to the next slide. Best practices is already covered. Then points to remember. Most of the points in this slide and the next few slides are already covered. If I had missed anything, I'll provide the link to this PPT in the description of this video. You can refer to it later. And everything that I had discussed in this video is part of a code lab. This is the link to the code lab. For more details, you can refer this code lab. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thanks for watching it. Bye bye.